Welcome to council. Tuesday, November the 7th. I'd like to call this meeting to order. I'd like to start with a moment of silence, please. Thank you. I have a disclosure of pecuniary interest and nature thereof by the director and director of council, please. Seeing none, we'll proceed. A lot of puppies around. I see Remembrance Day is coming up. I'm sure that was on everybody's mind in the last moment of silence. So just a reminder that the municipal offices are closed this Friday, November the 10th, in lieu of Remembrance Day. And on November the 11th, there will be a Remembrance Day ceremony commencing at 10 a.m. Here, and then in the Canton Cenotaph at 2 p.m. And you can visit and find this information on the Port Hope website at www.porthope.ca for more information. The deadline for the Mayor for the Day contest applicants is Friday, November the 10th, and to date we've received several applications and expecting a lot more. There's still time for the 7th and 8th graders to submit their applications. The student, Mayor for the Day, will spend part of the day with me on November 21 and will open council meeting that evening. And this is part of all the government day. Also, November is Women Abuse Prevention Month. Please show your support to end violence against women by participating in the province-wide Wrapped in Courage campaign. And again, that for more information, you can visit the cornerstonenorthumberland.ca site. On a county update, our next county meeting is scheduled for November the 15th. And November is Falls Prevention Month. And Community Care Northumberland helps you find your balance. Key statistics in Canada are as follows. Falls are the leading cause of injury among older adults. Falls in older adults account for $2 billion in direct health care costs annually. And over one-third of older adults will be admitted to long-term care after hospitalization for a fall. And falling can lead to depression, mobility problems, and loss of independence. So not to be lost, and I think it'll fit with some of our delegation perhaps later. Community Care Northumberland Falls Prevention classes, they have classes aimed to help seniors decrease these negative effects and potential injuries associated with falls and near falls. They've trained healthcare professionals leading these classes with several location options throughout Northumberland County. And for information or falls prevention class, please again visit the portal at commerce.ca. No provincial or federal update. And with that, I'd like to advise the public that we have had earlier a closed session. Advice that is subject to solicitor-client privilege, including communications necessary for that purpose in that section 239.2F, Parks, Recreation, and Culture, personal manager about matters about an identifiable individual, including municipal or local board employees, section 239.2B, and corporate services, a proposed or pending acquisition or disposition of land by the municipality or local board, section 239.2C. Nothing has come out of that. We are in recess. We will be resuming in-camera sessions. Closed sessions after the committee of the whole meeting. The consent agenda, we have 3.1 through 3.6. 3.1, counted. Council meeting minutes of October 17, 2017. 3.2, committee of the whole meeting minutes of October 17. 3.3, Special Committee of the Whole Meeting Minutes of October the 19th. 3.4, Special Council Meeting Minutes of October the 24th. 3.5, Public Meeting Minutes of November 1, 2017. And 3.6, Public Meeting Minutes of November 1, 2017. Could I have a mover, please? Moved by Councillor Andrews, second by Councillor Lees. Any discussion on any of these? All those in favor? Carried. There's no business from previous minutes and notification of new business. Seeing none, we'll move to petitions and delegations. And I would like to invite the Rotary Club representative up to the front, please. Red light, good, okay.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Paul Tate, and I'm the Rotary President for the years 2017-2018. And I'd like to thank Your Worship and Council for allowing us to present this evening. Port of Rotary was chartered in April 1922, and we're still around. Our first project was the Rotary Bridge in the park, and it's still there. So we've been around for the long haul. About 4 years ago, when the municipality did major renovations to the Jack Berger Sports Complex, we were asked for a contribution. At that time, we committed to $100,000 over 5 years. And I'm here this evening to present the fourth installment of that commitment. The funds were used to improve accessibility, which Rotary supports both locally and internationally. With many projects in the international field that helps the less disadvantaged around the world. As you may know, one of our international projects for the past several decades actually has been for the eradication of polio in the world. And from polio in dozens of countries and thousands of cases 30 years ago, we are now down to only 3 countries and under 30 cases so far this year. So I'd like to say that Rotary is a local club with a global reach. And with that understanding, I'd like now for our treasurer to present the check for $20,000 to whoever, His Worship. Okay. They will see that it gets to their appropriate place. Thank you.
Just stay up here for a minute, if you don't mind. I just want to say a couple of words. I mean, I'm honored, obviously, to have this check. It's a significant contribution, you know, to a great facility. And I can remember back in the 80s when the Jack Berger Complex was first proposed. And Rotary took a lead in that fundraising. At that time, it was a bit of a challenge because the club had not probably had such a large undertaking for quite a while. So the club embraced it, and I think it's also very appropriate that you're participating in the rejuvenation of this center at this point in time. So this is gratefully received and much appreciated, and I know, and anybody who contributes to the community knows how much effort it takes to get this. So thank you very, very much. Service clubs and all the people in the community who are doing so much to make this the community that it is. We have no correspondence. Staff and committee reports 7.1. Group Tunio, Director of Public Works and Engineering, regarding municipal challenges, fund grant opportunities. And there's a whole list of these. And we're going to recommend that these refer to resolutions. Can I have a mover, please? Councillor Hickey, Deputy Mayor. Any discussion at this point in time? Councilman Andrews?
Just two questions. You're indicating quite a large saving in kilowatt hours with the solar panels. Do we have any translation of costs for that?
Yeah, through Chair, we don't have the exact numbers at this time, but we know it's a, it's going to be a significant saving. We know it's around $400,000 to $500,000 we pay annually for the, in terms of hydro bills for the treatment plant. It's going to be significant savings.
Thank you. And the other question I have is, I know that, are you going for 100% grant funding or 50%? I know it says at the beginning of your presentation that 50% you would get more attention from the ministry, but at the end of your presentation you're saying that based on the consultant's report you're going to be going for 100% grant funding to the projects?
Through Chair, yes, the intention is to seek for 100% of the funding until unless there is a desire from the municipality to pitch in. These projects were not identified as part of the capital plans or other infrastructure improvements. So at this time, they are not unfunded projects, and the intention was to seek 100% funding for those projects.
Thank you.
Thank you. You read the report and the request, it clearly identifies a large need in the community, and it's done a lot of work in a short period of time to bring these to the attention, both the opportunity and in some cases where we're, you know, maybe deficient and have been in the past. So any further discussion? Those in Councilor Blake.
This is my first time at seeing this. A bit of a surprise and a shock. It adds up to a lot of money. Now, is there a contingency plan in place that it's, this is excellent if we get 100% funding that doesn't cost the municipality anything? But I mean, if we got half of these that are 50% now, it's all, we're taking taxpayers' dollars. What's the contingency plan? Are you prepared to walk away from projects if we can't get 100%?
This report is seeking council authority, through the chair. This report is seeking council authorization to proceed with a funding application and requesting 100% of the funding. If GHG program comes back and put some conditions on the town coming up with certain amount of funding, we will bring it to the council direction. We still have to check with the director of finance on how we can fund our portion of the projects, if we have to. Right now, our intention is to seek 100% of the funding. Until I know that if the municipality identified in advance that they are willing to contribute 10 or 15% of the project funding, it goes higher in the list of getting its success. So if there's a desire, we can add something on those lines. But at this time, our intention was to seek 100% funding. And if there's a direction, if you have come back to seek direction, we'll come back to the council.
Okay, thank you. You're looking for $1.2 million to put in a solar panel array. This council brought up prior to you taking your position back in February that we asked all departments to take a look at the potential of putting solar into place. Because of the cost savings at that particular time, we'd be under the FIT program. Are other departments going to have an opportunity to take a look at this or only works? Can parks take advantage of this or other buildings?
Through Chair, I understand Jim has been working with, in partnership with Hydro on getting certain funding on, specifically on the LED lights. On the solar panel, this we've made a request of $1.2 million only for the treatment plant, with the understanding that if we can get just $10 million in, that's that would be a great initiative.
I guess I need to clarify my question.
Okay.
Is this just for Works, or can other departments take advantage of this?
This request is on the
grant? No, but is the grant available to other departments, or is this only a Works Department grant?
This grant, through chair, this grant is available to other departments if they want to apply.
Thank you.
Councilor Betcher?
Thank you. I had a question similarly about the grant application. At Budget Committee, we had requests for some grant application, and I think we've talked about this before in terms of our individual departments looking for grants respective to their projects, or should we have a more comprehensive person within the municipality who's searching for grants for various infrastructure application forms, and also for, I know we have, under Parks we have some, under Works we have some, under Fire Services sometimes we even have some. So I'm just wondering if there needs to be a more comprehensive model to bring forward all of these grant applications together. So maybe that's something that, you know, directors can speak to in terms of when you have directors meetings in terms of discussing that. And I'm just curious why this is coming to council and it didn't come to Budget Committee. I don't know if there was a reason for that.
So through the chair, this actually did come through our financial analyst who does do the monitoring of the grants. And in the new year, we're actually trialing a new software that we can have access to for free initially that actually identifies all sorts of different funding options. Up until, I think about a week or two ago, we actually wouldn't have qualified to even apply for this grant. And because I think some of the barriers to entry for it were so high, they relaxed them. And so it's really just been in the past week or two, actually pleasantly surprised that Works and Engineering was able to work to put something in together. So when we were in our internal budget meetings, it was a discussion of we want to, you know, add or do things from other departments. But I think we've got, quite a good array of projects coming forward at this point, and the thought was not to add, and especially not to add some smaller projects for certain other things that we were doing. But this was quite last minute, and in order, this one's a little bit of an anomaly as well, that in order to be able to apply, we actually have to have a resolution of council just to apply for it. And really that is around the commitment of the plan. This is all tied to the plan, the greenhouse gas plan. So that's why in this instance, it is coming directly here as opposed to Budget Committee. And so it did kind of follow our process, but it was a very much a last minute change, because I believe previous to that, you actually had to have a whole plan pre-established, and I don't think there's many municipalities, and they weren't getting many applications. So hopefully this is an opportunity, but honestly, I hope we've got lots in the hopper, and most other municipalities weren't able to pull it together in time. So I appreciate the Works and Engineering did.
Any further questions or comments? All those in favor? Carried. We'll move on to the consent agenda resolutions. Is there anything here that council would like to pull out separately? We have 8.1, recommendations from in camera October the 3rd, local board committees. 8.2, recommendation from in camera October the 3rd, again, local board appointment. 8.3, recommendation from in camera October 17th, local board appointment, resignation. 8.4, recommendation from Works and Engineering, October the 17th, notice of motion, collection of residential waste and recyclables, Ward 2. 8.5, recommendations from Parks, Rec, and Culture, October the 17th, Port Hope Canada Day structure and budget options. 8.6, recommendation from Council, November the 7th, Municipal Challenge Fund Grant Opportunity. And I would ask for a mover and a seconder. Moved by Councillor Plitnik, seconded by Councillor Fletcher. Any further discussion on these? All those in favor? Carried. Then I'll move to bylaws. Moved by Councillor Hickey, seconded by Councillor Deese. Now therefore be resolved that bylaw 76-2017, being a bylaw to appoint Kermit Tunio as Director of Works and Engineering for the Municipality of Port Hope, and repeal bylaw 34-2004, be read at first and second time. All those in favor? Carried. I know we didn't need discussion, by the way. So. Zoning bylaw amendment ZB06-2017, 22 King Street, applicant Tova White. Comments?
At this time, I'd like to move that consideration of bylaw 77/2017 be deferred to the November 21st, 2017 council meeting to provide additional time for review.
So you're moving that? Okay. Second by Councilor Plickner. Any discussion? All those in favor? Carried. Thank you. Moved by Deputy Mayor Burns, second by Councilor Hickey. Now therefore it be resolved that bylaw 78-2017, being a bylaw under the provisions of section 34 of the Planning Act, RSO 1990, CB13, be amended to amend zoning bylaw 20-2010 as amended of the Corporation of the Municipality of Port Hope for lands legally described as Lot 4, south side of Ward Street, registered plan 11, all of PIN 51079-0011, in the Municipality of Port Hope, in the County of Northumberland, be ready first and second time. Discussion. All those in favor? That will be carried. Moved by Councillor Lees and second by Councillor Hickey. Now therefore be resolved that bylaws 76-2017 and 78-2017 be read a third time, passed, and that the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and the clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation and engrossed in the bylaw book. All those in favor? Carried. Is there a new and other business from councillors? I already gave you the county update. Question period, council? Press? Public? Seeing none, we'll adjourn and we'll start the committee of the whole meeting in about 5 minutes.